Cat Tales 22. I hallucinated for weeks in the hospital. Pink and gray cats climbed onto the windowsills, leapt the bedrails, and settled themselves heavily on my chest. During my months in an intensive care burn unit, my mother visited daily. She told me about the animal shelter near the medical center where she often stopped to walk the overjoyed dogs, as much for her therapy and relief as theirs. She mentioned the rows of large, mature, pouting cats peering out from behind wire mesh. Often left by infirm or deceased owners, she said you could read the bewilderment in their glaring faces. Stuck in my bed, all but motionless, I felt a kinship with those confused, scared cats down the road. During my long recovery, the same nightmare recurred. I came upon a house with a grand wraparound porch covered with mewing cats flicking their tails. More cats tumbled out of the rooms inside, but I held only a single can of tuna. The source of the cat dreams remained a mystery. Then a wise friend clued me in. Those crying cats are your unmet needs. In the dream I had two good hands, but in reality all 10 fingers had been claimed by the fire. Now, securing a leash onto the dog's collar ended in wrestling matches. But my mother's dog never reacted to my scarred face, he only wanted to romp. Once I moved out on my own, I missed the balm of animal presence. I felt abandoned by friends from my former active life and rejected by most people afraid of my looks. My face, a quilt of skin grafts, would require years of reconstruction. I was disabled. I had trouble repotting a plant. How could I manage an animal? How would I open the food cans? At a Boston animal shelter, I found myself prowling the stacked cages. Though I feared kittens' claws on my delicate grafted skin, I hoped to find a placid older cat that had already been declawed. Yet, I am normally against this procedure that robs a cat of its essential joy and defense. Cats use paws as hands. I identified with losing that dexterity. In the chaos of barking dogs and slamming doors, kids and couples cooed over the kittens. I rubbed a fuzzy head pressed against the bars, asleep. The gray sprawled in an unruly pose, nothing like the memory of my refined tuxedo, Gatsby. This cat was the color of lint. One paw extended upside down in full body stretch and hooked onto my sweater. Anything over 6 months is hard to move here, said the woman refilling water dishes. The card above the gray read, 2 years. Given up for allergies. After pulling me closer, the claws retracted. I had been chosen. As I wrote out a check, the washed-out calico shrugged off her yawns and strutted on the counter, flashing her white legs and one bar of orange tiger stripes. A white bib set off her faded colors. Her green-gold eyes fixed on the loose cockatiels behind the counter, while I stared at the lavish tattoos of dogs and cats decorating the clerk's forearms. "What will you name her?" my friend and driver Lily asked. When we'd hit the tunnel on Starro Drive, a crystal voice erupted from the carrier. As the volume swelled, her timbre said it all, opera. The plain Jane Grey with the high-tone voice would be Carmen. Carmen changed my perception of cat style. The force of her diva persona rescued me with her zest and spirit. She works a room. The repertoire, the swagger, the growl at any footsteps in the hall, the staccato chatter, questions in tonal muse, trills, and the lament. When I head out the door, the drama ensues. On cue, the actress races to the center of the living room rug, pirouettes, and topples with a wail or a pitiful eek, one paw draped over her face. I must plan ahead for helping hands for nail trims and carrier excursions. Needing cat assistance or cat sitting helped me meet neighbors, and to convert those unfamiliar with cat grace. Pets connect people to conversations and community. Amazed at how many people asked if I carry a wallet photo of my cat, I now do. Carmen anchors my day. At dawn, I feel the press of a paw on my face, gently hinting at the daggers beneath. From the window we watch the skyline come into color, and Carmen chirps through the screen to the pigeons that coo under the eaves. I manage to feed her, brush her with a wire curry, and scoop litter, because I must. In return, I live with a psychic roommate tuned to my every mood. Following my many surgeries, Carmen selects a bed corner and appoints herself Nurse Cat Sentinel. I had sought out a calm, older cat, but Carmen remains full of zest at 8 years old. All feline acrobats possess raw talent. Like the spring release of a taut rubber band, in a single fluid bound she uses the door ledge as a balance beam. She plays a jaguar, raking her 6-foot scratching tree. Still, though she wraps her 4 legs around my arm, she never claws me. I remember visiting a man whose cat rubbed on his wheelchair each time it passed by. Cats are agile in their loyalty, recognizing and expressing love in its myriad shapes and unconventional forms. My charismatic diva with the seemingly plain Jane coat is, to me, as lovely as she is loyal. Call her deluded, but I prefer pastel. In sunlight and in moonlight, my cat wears the plush sheen of Pussy Willow. A tricolor treasure who shimmers in her pale frosty coat, Carmen adds color to my days. And every evening, she settles heavily on my chest, my serene feline dream.